So, first of all, this is obviously the penis here. The head of the penis is called the glans penis, which is at 73 or at 12. The foreskin is also called the prepuce, which is here at 72. I would imagine, I wouldn't tag it on this model, so just 72 on this model. And the body or the shaft is 71 here, which would be this guy here. It's the body or the shaft. And then, can I see your list so I can read off of it? Then we have the external urethral orifice, which this model does have a number for it. It's number 13. It's the hole at the bottom right there.
Okay.
That's the external urethral orifice. This one has it as well, but there's no number associated with it. It's just where the hole is at the bottom.
Okay.
And then the scrotum. The scrotum is the outer sack of skin and fascia and fat that hold the testes. So this, all the stuff on the outside at H, that would be the scrotum. And then the testes are inside, which are, here's the testis and another testis there. The epididymis, so the sperm is produced at the seminiferous tubules at the testis, and then it moves eventually to the epididymis, which is here on this model, or B on this model. That's the epididymis. That's where the sperm would mature before they're able to be ejaculated.
Okay, it's still like a little like tube-looking thingy.
Yeah, right on top of the testis, and that guy right there as well. That's the epididymis. And then that would lead to the vas deferens, which is the pink duct, which is going up. You can see it on the other side as well through the spermatic cord. That's the vas deferens there. And then on here, it's the pink in the middle that's going here. And you can see it eventually over there. So that's all vas deferens. And then it's going to, at the very end of it, it becomes enlarged where it's the ampulla of the vas deferens, which is going to be that structure there on that side. Or you can see it on this side where here's the vas deferens, and then it gets a little bit bigger at the end. That's called the ampulla.
What does the ampulla do again?
It's just a part where the where it's going to meet up with what's called the seminal vesicle. So here's the big part of the vas deferens. That's the ampulla. That's the seminal vesicle. They come together to make the ejaculatory duct, which is right there. Or if you look on this side, you can see a number. It's number 63. That's the ejaculatory duct. And on this model, the ampulla would be right here at the end of the vas deferens. That's the seminal vesicle. And so it would form the ejaculatory duct, which you can see on this one right here.
Right there.
Okay.
And then from there, we have the, here's also the prostate gland is here. If you put this back on, you can see it from the outside. That's the prostate gland right underneath the bladder. If you look at this on the side, it's F on this model right underneath the bladder. That's the prostate gland.
Okay.
So then the urethra, which goes from the urinary bladder out through the that external urethral orifice, there's different sections, and so it's called different things that it's running through different parts of the reproductive tract. So urinary bladder again, and then the urethra, as it's going through, this is the prostatic urethra. As it passes through the prostate, this is the membranous urethra, or also called the intermediate part of the urethra, and then it's going to go through the spongiosum, the corpus spongiosum, and when it goes through that, it's called the spongy urethra, or you can also call it the penile urethra.
Do we need to know the spongiosum?
Yeah, so this is going to be the corpus spongiosum in blue.
Okay.
And then the one on top here, that's called the corpus cavernosum, if you're talking about one, but if you're talking about both of them in white, it's corpora cavernosa. That's the plural version. So it's the ones at the top. They all fill with blood, but the ones at the top, the cavernosa, those are the ones that make the penis like top heavy when they fill up with blood, that allows it to stand up erect.
Okay.
And I think that's the scrotal septum. So if this is the scrotum here on the outside, the sac of skin and fascia, here is a wall of connective tissue. That's the septum.
Okay.
Because there is a scrotal septum that separates the left and right testes. And then the spermatic cord, which I already showed you, this is the spermatic cord that holds the blood vessels and nerves and ducts. You can see it on either side, or either model.
The whole gray portion?
Yeah, that's all spermatic cord. And so inside of that would be the ducts and blood vessels and nerves.
Okay.
And that's it. Yeah, somebody air